A top CIA official for the Korean Peninsula warned Wednesday that the U.S. should be ready for a new provocation by North Korea on Columbus Day, October 9th, which coincides with the anniversary of the founding of the political party that governs Pyongyang. Stand by your phones, Yong Suk Lee, Deputy Assistant Director of the CIA's Korea Mission Center, said while speaking at a conference organized by the agency at the George Washington University. Lee did not speculate what North Korea might do, though it frequently carries out missile launches or nuclear tests on major state anniversaries, such as the birthday of leader Kim Jong Un or other dates associated with the lives of his father or grandfather. As the situation escalates, Defense Updates looks at a non-nuclear option that the U.S. has, which can swiftly bring North Korea's military to its knees. Let's go into the details.
Number 5.
Nukes were first used by the U.S. against Japan in 1945 during World War II. The U.S., Russia, China, and other countries have set off more than 2,000 nuclear test blasts since 1945. More than 500 of these explosions occurred on soil, in space, on barges, or underwater, but most of these happened early in the Cold War, before the risks to innocent people and the environment were well understood. Now we know much more. The problem with nuclear explosions is that they create radioactive fallout. Only a portion of a nuclear weapon's core is turned into energy during an explosion. The rest is irradiated, melted, and turned into fine particles. This creates a small amount of fallout that can be lofted into the atmosphere and spread around. A major nuclear strike on North Korea will have repercussions on the adjacent countries, namely South Korea, China, Russia, and Japan, as the atmosphere is likely to get polluted with the radioactive fallout. The problem with nuclear waste doesn't come to picture with Moab.
Number 4.
It's nicknamed Mother of All Bombs, but Moab actually stands for Massive Ordnance Air Blast. The bomb is officially known as a GBU-43B. The GBU-43B is the largest non-nuclear bomb in the U.S. arsenal. The basic operation concept of Moab bears some similarity to the Blue 82 Daisy Cutter, which was used to clear heavily wooded areas in the Vietnam War. Decades later, the Blue 82 was used in Afghanistan in November 2001 against the Taliban. Its successes as a weapon of intimidation led to the decision to develop the Moab. It was designed by Albert L. Weimortz Jr. in the Air Force Research Laboratory in 2003. The bomb was primarily developed as part of Iraq War's shock and awe strategy. Moab was first tested on the 11th of March 2003 on Range 70 located at Elgin Air Force Base in Florida. It was tested again on the 21st of November 2003. On the 13th of April 2017, a Moab was dropped on an ISIL Khorasan cave complex in Aachen District, Nangarhar Province, Afghanistan. It was the first operational use of the bomb.
Number 3.
Moab is a thermobaric weapon. A thermobaric weapon utilizes oxygen from the surrounding air to generate an intense, high-temperature explosion. The blast wave typically produced by such a weapon is of a significantly longer duration and more powerful than that produced by a conventional condensed explosive. The Moab is designed to hit targets such as surface facilities, tunnel entrances, and troop concentrations. Moabs are delivered from C-130 cargo planes, inside which they're carried on cradles resting on airdrop platforms. It's pushed out the rear of the aircraft it's launched from and uses GPS to guide it. It's purposely slowed down by a parachute. Shortly after launch, the drogues are released and bombs fall unretarded. The bomb explodes in the air, creating air pressure that can make tunnels and other structures collapse.
Number 2.
The bomb weighs at about 21,500 pounds, which translates to about 9,500 kilograms. For comparison, 9,500 kilograms is what two full-grown African elephants weigh, roughly. Since it's so large, it has to be dropped from the rear of a cargo plane. The Moab has a light 2,900 pounds aluminum casing surrounding 18,600 pounds, that's 8,500 kilograms, of explosive composition H6 material. The blast yield is equivalent to 11 tons of TNT. It's designed to explode 6 feet above ground and has enough power to obliterate anything in a 1,000 meter radius. For comparison, Hiroshima's Little Boy bomb had a yield of 13 to 18 kilotons, whereas Nagasaki's Fat Man bomb had a yield of 20 to 22 kilotons of TNT. Compared to nukes of today, even the smallest of the US military's atomic arsenal, the B-61, at its minimum configuration, has an explosive yield of roughly 30 times that of the Moab.
Number 1.
According to experts, Moab costs around $16 million per unit. So far, the US military has spent $314 million on production of these. USA has 14 of these ready to use anytime. Since the bomb is based on relatively modest technological concept, a large number of these can be quickly manufactured. Kim Jong Un's media machine reported this week that 4.7 million people offered to enlist in the North Korean armed forces in the days after President Donald Trump promised to totally destroy the rogue state. And the new recruits would more than quadruple the size of the nation's already mammoth military. With 1.1 million people in the armed forces, North Korea already has the fourth largest military in the world. North Korea is known to possess chemical weapons, CW, has demonstrated the ability to launch long-range missiles, as well as has tested nuclear bombs. A war with North Korea will be a race against time, since giving North Korea a chance to retaliate will result in catastrophe. A quick and decisive strike can be executed by the U.S. with its nuclear arsenal, but nukes tend to have long-term environmental impact, which may result in them not being a favorite option. In this scenario, Moab could be a viable option for the U.S. military planners.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.